estuviste de países con dictaduras, como Chile, la Argentina, ¿esos cineastas venían a lograr sus proyectos en Cuba o venían para entrenar en Cuba y luego volver a su país? ¿Cómo era la cuestión?
Bueno, a ver, los cineastas de esos países casi siempre lo que pasó es que salieron de sus países de origen y entonces de algún modo fueron a protegerse a Cuba, ¿no? O las obras de ellos fueron a protegerse y terminarse en Cuba. Ahora mismo, el año pasado, estuvo en Cuba la presidenta de Chile anterior, Michelle Bachelet, y nosotros le entregamos 94 obras, es decir, 94 películas chilenas que estaban guardadas en nuestras bóvedas y que ellos no tenían en su país. No estoy hablando de 94 largometrajes, sino 94 obras que habían sido o filmadas o realizadas por cineastas chilenos o por cineastas cubanos, pero que tenían que ver con Chile.
Del 73 para atrás.
De la época de la dictadura. Entonces, estas películas a veces se filmaban, sacaban las películas del país y las películas venían a Cuba y ahí se hacía la postproducción, ¿no? Se armaban esas películas, se ponían cuando se podían poner y algunas de ellas, por ejemplo, van a ser vistas por primera vez en Chile ahora.
Qué
Están en un
lindo.
proceso de restauración.
Muy bien, gracias. María, as we now go from Cuba to Argentina, being that this is about the business of filmmaking and you are the number one institution in Argentina for producing filmmakers, I'm curious to learn about Argentine cinema in your country, how Argentine cinema goes to Latin America, and does. Besides the fact that, the best foreign film award just went, an Academy Award for an Argentine film, how much Argentine cinema really does come to the United States, or does it go to other parts of the world?
Well, hello, good evening. Well, Argentine cinema doesn't go to the US, especially. I think the public of the US doesn't even know the Argentine cinema, even though we have just won an Oscar. That's not the kind of Argentinian films we usually make. Argentine cinema, it's the new Argentine cinema. We're going to talk about the new Argentine cinema. It's the one I can talk about. Normally, it's the cinema that has success in festivals, critics, but never with public. The public in Argentina or in other countries doesn't go to the cinema to see Argentine films. That's the truth.
So what are they watching?
The American films mostly. American films usually are the ones that fill all the cinemas. Argentina doesn't have a policy of promoting Argentinian films. We don't have a law that protects our own cinema. So that's why the Argentinian cinema goes to the cinemas for such a short amount of time, and all the tanks, as we call the American movies, fill the whole cinemas. The Argentinian films have a very tradition of good films, even festivals. We win prizes, festivals, but it's never about money. Argentinian films never make money. It's true. That's the truth. I don't know if in any country the artistic films make money or not, but the ones that we promote as a university that teaches filmmaking are the artistic films that are not the ones that make money, really.
And tell me also, I mean, what was interesting about our conversation was, and also that Argentines also, as much as they do see the popular U.S. cinema, they also are larger consumers of European cinema.
We have to divide the public into the general public consumes the American cinema, but the people that love cinema consumes most the European cinema. The filmmakers look to Europe, not to the US. to learn about cinema. The real filmmakers of the Nouvelle Vague in France, those are like the mentors of the New Argentine cinema.
Which would you say, I mean, it was part of our discussion earlier, which cinema do you think is the best in Latin America at this time?
Wow, what a tough question.
Slightly subjective, I mean, opposed to an archer tie. So.
I can say the Argentine cinema is the best, but I can say that the Cuban cinema, the Mexican cinema has a problem that the Mexican filmmakers are looking to the US. They try to cross the Rio Grande as soon as they can. So the good filmmakers in Mexico suddenly go to Hollywood, and there's the end of the Mexican cinema. But really, I think there's very good Brazilian cinema, there is very good Cuban cinema, and now there are some emerging countries like Peru that are beginning to have a very good cinema. You can see in the festivals like Berlinale or Cannes Film Festival, Peruvian movies winning awards. I think the small cinematographies are growing in all the countries.
Who is Argentina and Argentine filmmakers doing co-productions with?
Basically with Europe, because the money is there. It's the truth. We are making, Argentina produces around 100 films a year. Around 50 of them are supported by the National Institute of Cinematography, that's like the Italian thing, the Inca. But mostly they support like the commercial cinema, and then the other half of the cinema is like supported by the filmmakers with our support at Universidad del Cine and like cooperation with themselves. And there are a small amount of co-productions with Europe, especially with France and Spain.
Okay, thank you, Maria. Jeff, when she was touching on art films, not making money and stuff like that, can you touch on that? How has that experience been? When she says, you know,
sure,
art films really don't make money.
Well, I think that's certainly true. I think that at times they do, obviously. And the important thing is to try to find a way to sustain the structure of making the films. Because normally you're looking towards, in sort of the independent sector, you're looking towards bringing in equity investment. And in order to do that, you need to sort of convince them that there's a viable business model, which is extremely difficult. To do. It's funny, as they were speaking, I really thought of American independent filmmakers who are also under siege by Hollywood. In other words, to group all American films together is somewhat of a misnomer. And though I've produced films, and many of my films are distributed by the major distributors or the many majors, it still has the same feeling about it, that you have this onslaught that you have to confront, and there's a public that's really not amenable towards voices that are more challenging or more that are making films that are less about entertainment and more about providing some kind of challenge or an experience or an exploration. And similarly, as we're talking about Cuba, you know, I was almost envious to think, wow, there's actually a sort of organization you can go towards and have a conversation with and submit a proposal to and have a sort of a rational discussion, you know. I just got finished producing a film called The Kids Are All Right, which ultimately was sold to Focus, and it will be a relatively, for an independent film, it'll be a relatively major film, but it took 8 years to make, and ultimately the partners which we brought into the film are these horrible, beastly, conniving, just avaricious, people. It has nothing to do with art. Not even much to do with commerce, because rational investors won't go to film, they'll do something else. It's rational. So the people who invest in film are particularly, and they have money, so they feel entitled and all powerful. And they invest in film really to, in my experience, after 15 films, to really explore their sadomasochistic tendencies.
Like trauma.
Exactly. So it really, it's the job of the producer to try to mediate between that and the artistry that's happening in front of the camera or around the camera, which makes, I think, making film